Thank you, Senator. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I want to first start by recognizing your deep commitment to this mission. I've had the opportunity, of course, to participate in some of your trips abroad from a distance when I was in a different role, and I know the commitment you have to this mission supersedes any commitment to an institutional arrangement or a particular bureaucracy, and I look forward to working with you to put a change agenda in place so that USAID does live up to your aspirations and mine and those primarily of the thousands of people that are still involved in USAID programs around the world. I think this is an important opportunity and a little bit, in many ways, consider this a once in a lifetime or a once in a generation type of opportunity. The President, the Secretary, members of this committee, yourself, members of Congress, have all called for a more effective, a more transparent, and a more capable development enterprise. I think that is a legitimate call in an environment where our world is more interconnected and people care more about the development mission. I'm excited about being at USAID, and I'm excited because the agency has a rich legacy of successfully introducing the Green Revolution, of bringing oral rehydration therapy and other health solutions to millions of children, and of creating higher education institutions in part of the world, I was just in Pakistan, that stand the test of time, where graduates are proud to have been supported by U.S. generosity. But I also look and fully understand the need for change. And, you know, the examples are really everywhere. I was just in Afghanistan where our HR, where our staff there, including our very talented Foreign Service nationals, complained about not getting paid during a pay period. That's one example of where our HR system is failing us. There are others, but I think it highlights how acute the need is for performance improvement in many of our core operating functions. The planning, measurement, and capability to put together ideas and articulate them across the interagency, and as you put it, relate to the reporting capabilities of the agency, are very weak today. We, and now having been here for a few months with a big interagency focus on Haiti in particular, it took extraordinary measures for us to be able to produce the kind of data reporting and information on a daily and weekly basis so that our interagency colleagues can understand what's working, what's not working in the Haiti relief effort and try to fill gaps in a rapid way. We need to build better systems in that space. Our contracting model, as you highlight, needs real reform. I visited an institution just last week where we've provided about $4.5 million over probably 3.5 years and have done wonderful work in supporting thousands of students to gain access to technical training in Afghanistan. They will, at a cost of about $1,000 a student per year, they will graduate a two-year course and earn incomes of $300 to $500 a month in areas like the construction trades, electrical wiring, ICT, and computer programming. But we probably spend 35% more than we need to in order to get that $4.5 million to that institution. And having come from a place that had far fewer bureaucratic processes to address, I've seen development happen in a more efficient and a more direct way and think it can be done. So you asked very specifically about a reform agenda that would better serve U.S. taxpayers, and that is what we deeply believe in. Before the end of this month, we hope to roll out a new policy planning, evaluation, and budget capability at AID that will allow us to be more accountable and make smarter decisions and real resource trade-offs so that we're not just chasing every need in an environment where needs are endless. We've all been to settings where we are overwhelmed by the extent of needs, but we are focusing on those areas where we can get the most cost-effective impact and results for our investment. In June, I hope to launch a series of procurement reforms. This will not be easy because the agency has come to outsource a huge amount of work, including basic program design and program oversight activities. But we have a team in place. We've already put a board of acquisition review in place to review all large contracts over $75 million. And we will take that further in having really specific, detailed guidelines for procurement reform that are fundamentally based on the premise that we should be doing much more work in-house, especially related to program design and oversight. And finally, we will focus on HR and evaluation in a very substantive way over the course of the summer and the fall. I think if we do these things, sir, we will be a more accountable agency, a more transparent agency, and a more effective agency, and I share your passion and urgency around these points and appreciate your guidance in your opening comment. So thank you.